Mackinac Island today is a major resort location where each summer thousands of tourists enjoy the natural beauty and healthy climate of this island paradise. The island wasn't always a resort. Its location at the great juncture of Lake Huron and Lake Michigan has made it a very special place throughout its history. In 1873, the United States Congress was presented with a plan by the Michigan Senator Thomas Ferry to make Mackinac Island a national public park, second only to the Yellowstone National Park. That same year, the Indian Agency House, seen here, burns to the ground. At this time, the town is described as having 15 stores and curiosity shops, 3 steamboat docks, and 5 hotels with many boarding houses to accommodate the summer trade. In 1875, the United States government set aside 2 areas of the national park for cottage construction. The east and west bluffs were the selected sites. Within a few years, many lots were leased. After a lengthy survey period, homes were built on the western bluffs by wealthy industrialists from Chicago, Grand Rapids, Kalamazoo, and Detroit. One cottage was built for the Bishop of the Episcopal Diocese of Michigan,